The Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1974 was independent India's first dedicated environmental law. It set up India's pollution control boards, which are the backbone of its environmental regulatory architecture today. Nearly 50 years later, this backbone appears to be weakening. Have pollution control boards successfully been able to guarantee the right to clean water to the people of India? In a long-running case involving industrial pollution in the Pattancheru-Bolaram belt in Telangana, the Supreme Court of India and later the National Green Tribunal have passed countless directions to clean up sources of water pollution, to ensure the supply of safe drinking water, and to make polluters pay for the damage wreaked on the people's lives and livelihoods. But has the judicial wellspring finally run dry? This film tests the limits of the court's power as it traces the history of the legal battle that has been waged by the residents of Pattancheru-Bolaram and the environment lawyers and activists for their right to clean water.
Hyderabad is a growing metropolis. It is also a hub of bulk drug production, with a pioneering role in terms of making affordable medicine globally accessible. However, it is important to acknowledge that the pharma industry in the city is also one of the state's biggest polluters. The harmful chemical effluents released by these industries have ended up polluting the land, groundwater, surface water sources, such as wells, tanks, and lakes in their vicinity to such a degree that living there has become difficult.
అందరి ఇండ్ల ముంగట క్యాటిల్ తర్వాత బఫెల్లోస్ కౌస్ ఇవన్నీ ఉంటుండే వాళ్ళ జీవనాధారం సుఖశాంతులతో ఉంటుంది ఆ వెజిటబుల్ స్వీట్ అక్కడనే పంట వండి అవిటితోటి వాళ్ళ జీవనాధారం ఉంటుంది కానీ ఎప్పుడైతే 19 వెంగళరావు పీరియడ్ ఇండస్ట్రియల్గా ఎప్పుడైతే డెవలప్ అయిపోయిందో
A large number of industrial units set up from the 1970s in the industrial development area at Pattancheru and Bolaram have directly or indirectly discharged their trade effluents into the rivers and water bodies adjoining these areas. These effluents can travel hundreds of kilometers, polluting all water sources on their path.
ఎప్పుడైతే 80 తర్వాత దాని కాలుష్య ప్రభావము మనుషుల మీద ప్రకృతి మీద మొత్తము ఎఫెక్ట్ అయ్యింది మనుషులకు లేని వ్యాధులు రావడము
ఐ హావ్ సీన్ మెనీ మాల్ ఫార్మేషన్స్ ఐ హావ్ సీన్ ఇన్ వన్ విలేజ్ అబౌట్ 24 యంగ్ గర్ల్స్ కుడ్ నాట్ బికమ్ మదర్స్ ఐ హావ్ సీన్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ కేసెస్ క్యాన్సర్ కేసు దెర్ ఇస్ స్మాల్ హామ్లెట్ with about 15 to 20 houses wherein I've seen 12 cases of cancer
Gandhinagar mein bhi aisa nala mein pura pani chhod diya kon bhi ek aadmi BDP ke usme dale to factory fire ho gaya
This pollution is not about affecting the immediate community This pollution is about what is called as bioaccumulation And bioaccumulation implies that there is an uptake of the toxins and the hazardous waste that's dumped in these areas by crops, by fish, by cattle, right? By everything that perhaps is consumed. So in a sense, it comes into milk, right? And milk products. And these products are not really sold only in the local markets. They enter, wherever the market takes them. So they are entering the city, they are entering the plates of every elite person, perhaps in the be it 5-star hotels or be it the luxury villas. Everywhere the food that is being served, which is brought from these areas, be it fruits or any other kind of crop that is cultivated in these polluted areas, is extremely dangerous because it's carrying antibiotics, it's carrying all kinds of hazardous and toxic waste.
This widespread contamination led to major public unrest and judicial interventions from the 1980s. In order to address the immense level of degradation undergone in Pattancheru, the Supreme Court ordered compensation and remediation in the 1990s.
We had a people's movement from 84 to 90. And in the meantime, we filed a case, a writ petition was filed in the High Court of Andhra Pradesh. A lawyer written a letter to the High Court of Andhra Pradesh. Then the High Court has heard it, some orders were passed. Ultimately, nothing was implemented. Then M.C. Mehta got introduced. He filed a case, writ petition in the Supreme Court of India in 1990.
National Green Tribunal direction in 2017 was almost a culmination of what started in 1986.
Simulating the Bichri orders, that is, to provide water to the affected villages and to stop discharges, to provide medical help as back as about 30 years back. But nothing has been implemented till today.
ఇక్కడ కూడా కొన్ని భూములు నీళ్లు అవే వస్తుండే కదా
కెమికల్ వస్తాయి
ఇక్కడ భూములో కూడా
మా ఊరు అంతా దిగినాయి కెమికల్
కెమికల్ నీళ్ళు
కెమికల్ నీళ్ళే దాంట్లో వాటర్ డబ్బాలు పట్టుకొని చూస్తే కెమికల్ నీళ్ళే కానీ
ఇట్లా నిండి నట్టు అయింది మొత్తం కెమికల్స్ మాట రాలేదు ఊపిరి శ్వాస ఉషమ్మ హాస్పిటల్ తీసుకెళ్తే మా వాళ్ళు అడ్మిట్ చేసుకుని సీరియస్ అని చెప్పేసారు ఏసీతో పంపించారు ఇదంతా అమ్మోనే నిండిందని ఇక్కడ గొంతుకు ఆపరేషన్ చేసి తీసేసారు ఇప్పటికైనా డాక్టర్ టాబ్లెట్లు అది పెయ్యంత అది కెమికలే ఉందమ్మా చూసి వాటర్ కొనుక్కొచ్చుకొని తాగాలి వాసనకు ఉండకూడదు
సో ఓవరాల్ ఇఫ్ యు లుక్ అట్ ఇట్ ఇట్ వాజ్ ఓన్లీ ఏ ఫైట్ అట్ కంటైన్మెంట్ రాదర్ దాన్ సొల్యూషన్ కాంప్రహెన్సివ్ సొల్యూషన్
ఇండస్ట్రియల్ యూనిట్స్ క్లెయిమ్ దట్ దే హావ్ అచీవ్డ్ zero liquid discharge. Scientific experts and environmental activists refute this claim.
And from past 20 days, there is a foul smell from the lake what we see here. Because of this foul smell, small children and old people and young adults, we cannot survive here. We cannot stay here. What is happening here?
Tribunal has ordered to attain zero discharge within 6 months. Now I think 2 years are over, so they have not attained. Still, if you go to the site, you might have seen various areas wherein the zero is not attained, and they asked to remediate all the tanks. As in 1990, वहाँ से Supreme Court जो बोली ना, आज तक remediate नहीं करे वो लोग.
Supreme Court has given several judgments, including the idea of setting up a health center, having proper records of the water being collected and quality of water being monitored. partially, you know, some of these have been implemented. It's a renovation of the entire lakes. None of it, you know, has actually substantively happened.
One is the zero liquid discharge, which was given as a solution and which was accepted by Supreme Court, had lot of limitations. One is it was a conversion, not a treatment. And second, you are again deal with the solid waste which is left behind. And no one is there to look at the air pollutants which are allowed into the atmosphere. But after 19 years or almost 20 years of that JLD process, we see that groundwater pollution is continuing. So in Patancheru case, they allowed, even the High Court allowed then to two industries, you know, cellulose industries to dump their effluents into Kukatpally main, which joins Hussain Sagar and then Musi. And for some industries, they were actually permitted to dump effluents directly in the Ambarpet treatment plant. So both of them were only relief for the industries, not for the environment and not for the people. Later on, because they knew that this is only temporary, then the idea of common effluent treatment plant came up. The entire principle was unscientific. You know, when you mix different effluents without any primary treatment, no one knows what is the reaction. And this was given as a solution to the Supreme Court as well.
The legal battle has given a lifeline to the polluters than to the people.
Polluter pays principle has, while on paper it is there, in law it is there, but in spirit it has not really been applied in a manner that either that it acts as a deterrent to the polluter, or that it has adequately compensated the victim. None of this has actually happened. And that is the advancement. And we are here talking about 25 years of damage and compensation not being paid. So that's the tragedy of our regulatory process.
Oka judge emo court avi factory meeda stay istadu, closure run istadu, malla tellare inko judge daniki open gurinchi istadu, em jare.
So what I mean to say, the legal battle is an unequal fight between the petitioner and the powerful industrialists.
On the one hand, remediation efforts are far from effective, and on the other hand, victims from this region have suffered, waiting endlessly for just compensation.
తాగదామన్నా బర్ల గొర్రెలకు నీళ్ళు లేవు, బర్ర రాసిపోతే గొర్రె రాసిపోతే ఇప్పుడు మొత్తం 400 ఉండే జీవం నాకు, 400లలో ఇప్పుడు ఎంత ఉందంటే నాకు 100 జీవం ఉంది, ఆ 100 జీవం కూడా బాలేదు. ఈ 40 ఏళ్ళకు పోతే నష్టపరిహారం ఇవ్వమంటే ఇయ్యరు వాళ్ళు,
నష్టపరిహారం
ఇయ్యరు. భూమి ఖరాబ్ అయింది ఇస్తామని చెప్పారు కంపెనీ వాళ్ళు, కానీ అది ఇచ్చడమే లేదు.
ఆరో ప్లాంట్ వలన ఏదో జీవం తాడని మాత్రం నీళ్ళు వస్తున్నాయి, కడుక్కోవడానికైనా పిండుకోవడానికైనా ఏం చేసుకోవాలని కూడా ఏంది ప్రాబ్లం అని చెప్పేసి మేము కనీసం ఇక్కడ చూపించుకుందామంటే హెల్త్ క్యాంప్ లేదు. హెల్త్ క్యాంప్ లేనప్పుడు గవర్నమెంట్ హాస్పిటల్ లేదు, గవర్నమెంట్ లేనప్పుడు ఇక్కడ ఈఎస్ఐ ఉంది, ఈఎస్ఐకి మాకు సర్వత లేదు. మాకు ప్రైవేట్ హాస్పిటల్కి వెళ్తే పోయి ఓన్లీ చెక్ చేసినందుకు 5,000 రూపాయల నుంచి 10,000 వరకు ట్రీట్మెంట్ నడుస్తుంది. ఆ ట్రీట్మెంట్ పెట్టుకోవాలంటే మొత్తం డబ్బు లేని పరిస్థితి. మా పంట పండించుకుందామంటే పంట లేదు, ఇక్కడ బోర్ వేసుకుందామంటే నీళ్ళు పడాయి. ఎటు పోయినా అంత విచ్చలవిడిగా పరిస్థితి.
Filed that case in 1990, the big victory at that time was Supreme Court ordering 32.26 crores of compensation.
When people came together in the case of Patancheru, and when they saw that they were getting lot of orders from High Court and Supreme Court in their favor, they thought they won the battle.
NGT judgment, we find expert committee in the same area in Jahirabad and Piramal company case, they again ordered 1,000 rupees per acre, which looks ridiculously low because now you take any crop, average is per acre cost, any crop is at least 1 lakh rupees per acre. So again, the polluter liability principle was not applied completely.
The government should have been honest and implemented. But governments are simply towing the corporates.
The PCB is not doing its job, and that's, let's be very blunt about it. And because of the failure of an institution which has to come to the rescue of the citizens, given the fact that, environmental impact assessments are very expensive. So to actually identify what are the chemicals or heavy metals and so on, and then to establish, their quantity, is a hugely expensive affair. And that's where organizations like the PCB have to be continuously keeping a tab on the quality of water, soil, air, and then supplying the community with the information.
I feel very sorry that the Supreme Court and the NGT, which has passed so many orders, they did not bother to create a mechanism. They should have created a body to ensure the compliance of their own orders.
Which means that trust factor has gone even on the committees and the members who are coming as part of these committees.
The committee which was set up by the, appellate court, the chairperson of which was former advisor to the Bulk Drug Manufacturers Association. Now, what is the credibility of that kind of a committee? So therefore, this is a clear conflict of interest, and one doesn't know how credible those kinds of reports have been.
This whole situation as on today, present situation is, it's the government's horseshoe policy. किसी हर्षो मिल गया और घोड़े को ढूंढने गए, ऐसे हो रहा है. इंडस्ट्री आ गया, फिर 15 साल तक आप इंडस्ट्रियल वेस्ट डिस्पोजल सिस्टम प्लान ही नहीं करे.
दैट पब्लिक स्टैमिना इज लिमिटेड.
सो आई स्टार्टेड यंग एंड आई एम बिकमिंग ओल्ड, बट द पोल्यूशन कंटिन्यूस.
स्टिल हजार्डस वेस्ट, टॉक्सिक वेस्ट स्टिल गेट्स डंप्ड आउटसाइड द प्रेमिसेस ऑफ द इंडस्ट्री. इट रीचेस द लेक्स, इट पर्कोलेट्स इनटू द ग्राउंड वाटर. It is causing serious health disorders. So 2.5 decades is quite a significant time. And if courts have not been effective, then one has to really, it's for the courts to protect their own dignity and respect. Community has always been looking towards the courts for some justice and some sense of relief.
People have changed their mindset and are moving away from their birthland, knowing very well that they have no future here.
और एक हमारा तालाब का पीछे जमीन हो, 100 एकड़ जमीन है, उसमें किसका भी गांव वाले को जमीन ही नहीं है, बेच के बाहर चले जा रहा.
ये गांव में पूरा इतना आदमी की बहुत तकलीफ है, बोलते बहुत तकलीफ है. 5-5-50 साल होने के बाद जिंदना बन लो तो बहुत तकलीफ है, मरने का है मगर जिंदना तो बेस्ट है. अभी हम लोग का सूरत, हमारा सूरत 40 साल है, अभी मेरा सूरत देखो कैसे हो गए, हमारा बच्चे लोग कैसे होना, उन लोग कैसे जिंदना, जिंदना बोलो तो बहुत मुश्किल है. ये गांव में रहना बोलते भी बहुत मुश्किल है, हमारा भी नहीं, और लेडीज लोग भी गर्भा संचय रहते ना, वो भी निकल जा रहा है.
ये कालुष्य गुरी मोटमोदू पेद उद्यम ऊरेगि कलेक्टर को रिप्रजेशन तरह गवर्नर को रिप्रजेशन स्पीकर को रिप्रजेशन ఇవన్నీ చేసినాం. తర్వాత హైకోర్టుకు పోయి రిప్రజెంటేషన్లు చేసినాము, ఎన్ని చేసినాము. తర్వాత సుప్రీంకోర్టులో పిటిషన్ పెట్టినాము, చెన్నై కోర్టులో పిటిషన్ పెట్టినాము, ఎక్కడ కూడా మాకు న్యాయం జరగలేదు. ఒక స్పారోస్, ఒక కాకులు గ్రహించినాయి ఈ ప్రాంతము నివాసయోగ్యం కాదు అని చెప్పి అవి వెళ్ళిపోయినాయి. అయినా అని మనుషులము కాబట్టి ఇంకా వేరే ఆధారం లేక అట్లే ఉన్నాం. న్యాయం గురించి కోర్టుకు తిరగడం అనేది పిచ్చి. ఎవరైతే ధనవంతులు, ఏదైతే ఇండస్ట్రియలిస్టులు ఉన్నారో వాళ్ళకి మట్టుకే న్యాయం దొరుకుతుంది. వాళ్ళు ఎంత తప్పులు చేసినా అని వాళ్ళకి న్యాయం, మనకు న్యాయం దొరకదు. మేము గ్రహించిన మీది